Hi everybody, I'm Clint with Flatwater Incorporated. We're the manufacturers of Sharkhide metal protectant as well as the other Sharkhide products. Today what we want to talk about is how to recreate a new finish on your boat. Let's say you've had Sharkhide on your boat for years, but you've got it rashed up from rubbing docks, bumpers, what have you. Or maybe like this gentleman had a boat that they bought brand new and didn't put Sharkhide on it at first. So what we need to do is create a new finish, a new look for the boat, get it back to a nice uniform look. We know how to help people with three different types of finishes. We have the simplest, which is just simply the aluminum cleaner and you're done. The next is a hand rubbed finish, which we're going to be doing here. The third is a polished finish, which we'll do a video on that separately. That's a pretty in-depth process, so we'll get to that separately. But back to the hand rubbed finish, what that does is it gives the boat sort of, it reminds you of the backside of a sheet of aluminum foil, that nice muted silver color, but we put a directional grain in it. That helps to hide any blemishes on the boat, little pock marks from salt corrosion, things like that. The hand rubbed finish requires no special tools or equipment. It's a relatively quick job. I mean, start to finish is in the neighborhood of 3 hours plus or minus a little bit, and that pretty much is all it takes to do the whole process from the time we start till your first coat of the metal protectant. So let me talk about the materials you're going to need for this. Now, what you're going to need to start, we're going to need the Sharkhide aluminum cleaner. This is what we're going to be beginning with. That's step number one. Now, the aluminum cleaner is going to get rid of all the oxidation, all the discoloring on the hull, and bring it to a nice uniform finish, which happens to be kind of an off-white look. Now, the second step, we're going to use these abrasive pads. These are actually 3M Scotch-Brite pads. We only use 3M. We've tried the cheaper import stuff. You don't get the same result. First of all, we use a coarse pad to establish the grain in the boat, followed up by the medium pad, which lessens the depth of that grain, followed by the ultra fine pad, which sort of knocks the tops off the ridges and gives it that real nice muted silver color. So once we're done with the abrasive pads, that's step two. Step three is we apply the Sharkhide metal protectant. And all we need for that tool-wise is the special cloth, bird's eye weave flat fold cloth. That's what we're going to use to apply the protectant. Okay, so those are the materials. That's going to be the job for the day, is create the hand rub finish on this boat. Oh, a little bit about the boat, first of all. This boat was purchased new August of last year. So it's only been used from August till the end of the boating season here in the Midwest. And the finish has gone from that real nice shiny mill finish to this. You can see all different shades of darkness from water lound down. It's virtually black, but the finish is nice and smooth. It's not been left in the water. This is what can happen to your nice new finish without the Sharkhide metal protectant. But we're going to see what we can't do to bring this thing back to life for these guys, and we'll see you in a minute. We'll get started. We're just about ready to get started creating our hand rub finish on this boat, and the first step of that process is hitting it with the aluminum cleaner. But this is so new. This rig is purchased new last August. But if you look down, they've got some polished diamond plate type of tread plate type of aluminum sheeting down here, and there's still a lot of life left in that. So before I started spraying the aluminum cleaner on here, I didn't want the runoff to hit that, because it would etch that off white also. So that's where our Sharkhide aerosol comes in handy. What we're going to do with that, we're going to take the aerosol spray. I'm going to take just a little piece of cardboard that we've got to kind of block off, to kind of, you know, prevent some of the overspray. And what we're going to do is we're going to hit these little aluminum pieces first. See, we'll just hit them with the Sharkhide spray first. All right, and what that's going to do is it's going to protect this aluminum from the cleaner when we go to spray the cleaner on. So that way it'll maintain this real nice shiny silver look. So again, just an old piece of cardboard or anything, and just give it a good spray. And that will be sufficient. So when we're done with the aluminum cleaner, any runoff, anything that comes from the cleaner and lands on this won't etch it. So that's just a little tip. So if you're gonna be doing your boat on the trailer, look out for your bright aluminum. If you wanna protect it, hit it with the aerosol before you use the cleaner. Now we're gonna get started with the cleaner. As soon as that dries, in about 2 or 3 minutes, we're ready to start. Okay, we've hit the diamond plate with a coat of Sharkhide, a couple coats of Sharkhide. That'll keep it from being damaged by the runoff. We talked about that earlier. So now we're ready to start applying the aluminum cleaner to the hull. That's step one. We gotta hit the whole hull with our cleaner and get that nice off-white look. Right off the bat, I want to tell you, I'm breaking my own rules, and I want to address that. I tell my customers, rubber gloves, long sleeves, long pants. The only reason I'm doing it like this is I've got a nice breeze to my back. I'm always constantly aware of keeping the breeze to your back when you use the cleaner. You don't want to have the overspray landing on you for any reason at all. And if you do, immediately stop, go rinse, go clean yourself off. We don't want anybody hurt. So here's what we're going to do. We got our mixture of aluminum cleaner. What I did is I did two parts of water, one part cleaner. We've got the adjustable tip. I got it turned off now, so see there's nothing comes out. Now if you open it up, we can get a stream out of it. So what we want to do is we want to turn that nozzle off to where nothing sprays out. Then a little trigger pressure and slowly unscrew it until you get your finest little fog that comes out of that. Okay? That's where we want to set it at. So just like in our cleaner videos, we're gonna do the same thing on here. Dry aluminum, work from the bottom up, go 6 to 8 feet maximum, and that's it. Now, one thing I wanna talk to you about is normally we take these trim panels off, but in this particular case, these are welded to the boat, I can't get them off. So what we're gonna do is block these from the overspray from the cleaner. We don't wanna etch this. This is a nice shape still. So I take a little piece of cardboard, I'll stick it up underneath there, and I'll just work my way down the boat, use this as a shield when I spray in that area. So, bottom, work your way up, and then when we get up here, just make sure you don't get any of the aluminum cleaner on the side panel. Now this is some pretty heavy oxidation. So we're probably gonna have to do a couple of coats on this to really get it to etch down here on the bottom. But you can see on the top, it's already etching, you know, so we're already getting a good reaction up here. So down below we have mineral buildup, very slight, but enough to slow down the cleaner. We get calcium, lime, things like that that build. But it's, you know, nothing to worry about because it will etch through that eventually. So what we do is we just keep working here, and whenever you see bare aluminum pop through, you want to give it another spray of the cleaner. And you see some of the areas down here on the bottom now are beginning to etch through now. So eventually we're going to get full coverage out of that. Cardboard back up. So now we're just down to the very bottom. We're getting a good reaction. So you can see that dense layer of foam everywhere. That's what we want. And these couple of dark spots here that are still exposed, just keep hitting it until you get the reaction you're looking for. Now you can see up here the aluminum is starting to be exposed. The foam is running down. So what we'll do is we'll just mist that again in those areas. We want to keep it under a blanket of this foam. Usually 2 to 3 minutes is what I like to see people do. All right, we've had our cleaner on here now for a minute or two. 3 minutes is usually more than enough, but couple of minutes so far. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hit it, and when I rinse it, I want to rinse from the top down like this. I don't want to shoot and drive the cleaner up underneath there because the rinse water will come back down and it can still etch the pontoon because it's got the cleaner mixed in with it. So we'll shoot from the top down and rinse it. Rinse off the diamond plate. Now, as you can see, it etched the pontoon an off-white color as compared to what it started out as, but we want to make sure this is rinsed real good. But you can see the diamond plate, the aluminum has been protected by the metal protector. So we do these in small sections so we can keep up with the runoff. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to work my way down the boat, and we're going to get this whole pontoon this nice uniform off-white like we got here. Okay guys, we've finished up with the aluminum cleaner now. You can tell a drastic difference between the old finish and what we've got here. I did this real quickly. I didn't do the 3 minutes per section like I normally do, but you know, we were gonna cover this up real quick with the hand rub finish, so it wasn't that critical to get a perfect job with the cleaner. So here's what we do now. Step two is we're gonna now create the grain with our three different pads. Step one, again, was a cleaner. Step two, we're gonna create the grain. Step three is the Sharkhide. So the way we establish our grain, we start off with the maroon pad or the coarse pad. And what you wanna do is you wanna make sure it's always working under a trickle of water. You always wanna keep a little bit of water running down to keep your pad rinsed, to keep the metal rinsed. And what we're doing is we're just gonna work in horizontal strokes. Forward, backward, we're gonna go horizontally only. You never wanna swirl, you never wanna go at angles because that's something you're gonna have to address then later. So forward and backward like this, we go from the top of the pontoon to the bottom, and what you wanna do is after you've used her for a few seconds, always flip your pad, keep moving to different, holding it from different positions and things like that, because wherever your hand is at, that's where you're getting the most force through there, and you're only cutting with that area. So if you keep moving around, that'll give it more of a uniform pattern here. The grain will be more uniform. So forward and backward only. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna work our way down the boat, just like this. Now don't concern yourself with how this pattern looks. It's not gonna look very good when you're done, but we're gonna address that later. So the main thing is get a good deep grain cut in it first with your coarse pad. Once you get that cut in, we're gonna come back with the medium and do the same thing. So what I like to do is go around the boat a couple of times with each pad. You don't have to spend a lot of time in any one area. If you see a bit of a water line, you could work there just a little longer to try to even it out. But what we're trying to do here is just establish a grain. So I'm gonna do this with the coarse pad all the way around the boat two or three times. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get rid of the coarse pad and I'm gonna move to my gray or medium pad. We're gonna do the same thing all the way around the boat, always under a trickle of water. You see the black that's showing up here? We always wanna keep that going. So we'll go two or three times around the boat with the medium pad, and then finally we're gonna go a couple times around the boat with the ultra fine pad. Okay, so I'm gonna do that now, and then we'll rejoin you, show you the last step with the pads. I don't know if you can see it or not, but we're finished. We've gone all the way around the boat with our Scotch-Brite pads. We did the coarse, the medium, then the ultra fine. We're now getting ready to do the final step in the hand rub finish. All these lines, and again, it's probably hard for you to see the grain in here, but it's irregular. It starts and stops. It's not straight, waves and such in it. But the last step in creating this finish is the greatest of all. It's the simplest, and it's amazing how simple this is. To get all these back into alignment, to make it look machine laid, that's our goal. We want this grain to look like it was machine laid while these sheetings were being produced at the plant. So here it is, here's our secret weapon. The way to get all this in alignment and make it look great, we take brand new ultra fine Scotch-Brite pad, and you ready for this? A sponge mop. Now what we do with this, it's a plain Jane sponge mop. All we're going to do is we're going to wet the hull down. We're going to wet the sponge mop, wet the pad. Now it'll hold itself there. You don't have to wrap it or anything. We place it against the hull. Now take your lead hand and hold right at the base as hard as you can, because you're going to be putting down a lot of down pressure. Now your trailing hand, you're going to grab the handle. Now if you pull your trailing hand too far up, you'll notice the nose of this will dig in and cause an irregular finish. If it's too close, the back end digs in. So your lead hand is what you're going to put all the pressure with. The trailing hand, you want to keep that adjusted to where that sponge mop sets flat. So what we're going to do is we're going to wet the whole surface down. We're going to wet the pad and the sponge mop. Now in one fluid movement, you don't stop, you just walk at a comfortable pace, you walk the full length of the boat, turn around, walk the full length back, all while keeping lots of down pressure on the boat and keeping this as straight as possible. So what that does is that takes all these random scratch marks, each pass where you go back and forth, it aligns them, it makes them straight, so as you're looking down the length of the boat, this grain ends up looking machine laid. It's a beautiful finish. All right, so I'm gonna get started on this right now, see what we can do. Okay, now as you can see, these are actual metal showing up on this darkness. So what we want to do is after each, two or three passes, rinse your pad down real good, rinse the boat down real good, and start all over. So the good thing about this, you can't overdo it. No matter how many passes you make, it's strictly up to you. I mean, this portion of the job, the more passes you make back and forth, the more of the light silvery appearance it's going to take on. Go as many times as you want until it appeals to you. Once you get it looking the way you like, you're done with this step. I'm done now with the sponge mop and with the pads. I've got a nice straight horizontal grain running the length of the boat. It's all done. What we're going to do now is one last little wash down. What we use is just any kind of cloth. A microfiber is fine, so we don't scratch anything. Just regular rinse water, a microfiber, wash it down, because we're going to get a lot of black out of here. A lot of the old metal particles are still in the grain. We're going to wash it. We're going to chamois it down, let it air dry 2 or 3 hours. Then the final step, we're going to put a fresh coat of Sharkhide metal protectant on it. So, okay, here's something I want to show you folks, is we're chamoying off the water on this thing. This is very important. You chamois the boat down, but got to look out for things like this. See how this is running down? If we allow that to run and dry, that'll leave a permanent stain on there. So what we want to do is after we chamois the boat, we just got to kind of keep coming back, keep going round and round the boat, make sure we catch all these little runs and don't let them get established. Now here's a little trick we do. After you get done with the final wash and rinse, take a leaf blower, blow up underneath here, blow up under your cross members, any place water may hang out, and that leaf blower helps force the water away from the finish. But in this case, we don't have one, so I just have to stick around, chamois it off, and just keep up with them. Don't let them run and dry. But that's a little tip to keep a better looking finish. All right, well, here we are in the final step, applying the Sharkhide metal protectant. We'll put the first coat on here. We'll let it set 2 or 3 days. I'll come back with my second coat, and then the job will be complete. So I've got my my cloth, nice and thick, folded up about a nice 4x6 rectangular pad, all loose ends folded inward. Take my Sharkhide, and we're gonna dribble all over the face of this cloth. We're going to wet it equally. We want it equally wet until it just does start to feel like it's reaching through to your hand. See, it's just starting to come through. Okay, so now we've got enough Sharkhide on the pad. Now what we're going to do is I'll put the first coat on the boat and we'll see you soon. All right, everybody, well, that was it. That's the hand rubbed finish, start to finish. Three major steps, we covered them all. The aluminum cleaner first, followed by creating the texture or the grain in your pontoons, and then followed up by a couple of good coats of Sharkhide. And as long as you take care of the Sharkhide, this boat will look the same 5-10 years from now. Quite a difference, I would say, between before and after, wouldn't you say? So all of this is done at home by hand, typically a 3-hour job plus, you know, something any one of you can do at home. So hope this helped answer some questions. I hope this gets you interested in recreating a new finish for your boats. So give me a call anytime. I'd be more than happy to help. You can call me at 618-910-8890, or you can contact me through my website at sharkhide.com. Thanks for watching. Thank you.